centre of the British helicopter industry and headquarters of the Westland Group of Companies, now incorporating Saunders-Roe Division, Fairey Aviation Division and Bristol Helicopter Division, developing and manufacturing a range of helicopters capable of meeting a wide field of civil and military requirements throughout the world. Extensive development facilities are backed by over 20 years' experience of rotary wing aircraft. Additional strength comes from collaboration with the Sikorsky Division of the United Aircraft Corporation, with whom license agreements were concluded when Westland turned from fixed-wing production to the manufacture of rotary-winged machines after the Second World War. With this background of skill and experience, British helicopters are playing their part in military and commercial operation throughout the world. The most significant development applied by Westland has been the introduction of gas turbine engines. These engines give better power-to-weight ratios, quicker operational starting, improved operating economy, and lower noise levels. These are the engines powering Westland helicopters. Helicopters that can operate under almost any conditions and that can land and take off vertically from restricted spaces and unprepared sites. That can move engineering hardware direct to the assembly site quickly and easily without regard to ground conditions. That can work as flying cranes, moving civil and military passengers and freight. That can tow loads many times their own weight. Here you see the Westland Wessex towing a combined load of prime mover and two trailers loaded with liaison helicopter, light transport and armored vehicle. The Wessex is the first large turbine helicopter to go into quantity production in the Western world. Troops can be flown at short notice to the operational area. Areas can be quickly evacuated. Designed primarily as a shipborne search-and-strike anti-submarine helicopter, the Wessex Mark I is now in service with the Royal Navy and the Royal Australian Navy. Operating from its carrier base, missions are carried out fully automatically in all weathers, by day or by night. Powered by a Napier Gazelle free turbine engine, the Wessex can ferry loads up to 4,500 pounds or carry 16 fully equipped troops. This helicopter has a maximum speed of 115 knots and a ferrying range of 500 nautical miles. Submarine patrol is a vital task of today's carrier force. The Wessex is fitted with automatic stabilization equipment and flies to the area under automatic control. The big helicopter comes to the hover at precisely the right height. Sonar operators are at their stations, and down goes the detector buoy. The crew monitor the data as it's relayed to the cabin. A development of the Wessex Mark I, the Bristol-Siddeley Gnome twin-turbine-engined Wessex II, specially designed for high-altitude general-purpose work, has been chosen by the Royal Air Force for transport duties. Good single-engine capability makes this helicopter particularly suitable for civil operation between city centres and over water. This machine, together with the Wessex Mark III and V, with uprated Gazelle and twin Gnome installations, give a range of aircraft and a choice of power unit capable of meeting a variety of requirements. Versatility is the keynote of the Wessex range. Companion to the Wessex is the turbine-powered Gnome Whirlwind, an 8 to 10-seat general-purpose transport helicopter powered by a Bristol Siddeley Gnome free turbine engine. In service with the Royal Air Force and the Republic of Ghana, the Gnome Whirlwind has been evaluated under a variety of operating conditions. One port of call was in the Austrian Alps to test the machine under high-altitude conditions. Equipment is loaded into the aircraft and the troops, 10 in all, are all set to ascend the 12,000 feet of the Grossglockner mountain range. Under alpine conditions, the Gnome Whirlwind can take off from a base at 4,000 feet, carrying a medical attendant, 6 stretchers and medical equipment, climb to 10,000 feet and rescue up to 6 casualties by winch within a radius of action of 125 nautical miles. Already in service with operators all over the world, the Westland Whirlwind, powered with either piston or gas turbine engines, is well suited to carry a wide variety of loads in its boxcar fuselage. Among its uses are trooping, passenger and freight carrying, and the ever-important role of search and rescue.
Well, we have a tea or coffee?
Tea.
That's fine, don't have to. 22. Hello, RPC.
I'm ringing the bell.
Yeah, this is Scramble, Barry. Yes, go ahead, old boy. Aircraft crash. Single seater, 10 nautical miles west.
Scramble Petro 59 to aircraft crash at Tintagel, 1 occupant.
A distress call, and the Royal Air Force swings into action. First on the spot, the crew scan the sea for the ditched pilot. Soon spotted, and the helicopter makes for the area. The pilot looks in good shape, down goes the winch. In seconds, the pilot attaches the harness, and up he comes. Slowly and gently, he is hoisted aboard, and within minutes is on his way back to base. The Westland Scout is a 5 to 6 seat turbine-powered light helicopter. A weapon carrier for the Royal Navy and designated the Wasp, it's in service with the British Army and fulfills a wide variety of roles in the fields of rescue, casualty evacuation, liaison and signals duties. The Scout has been specifically designed as a fast, compact, highly maneuverable, high-performance helicopter to meet the tactical requirements of the Army in the field. Fully equipped for day and night operation in almost all weather conditions, turbine power makes light of high-altitude tasks. Operating as a shipboard weapon carrier, the Wasp plays its part in a fully integrated naval weapon system. Equipped with homing torpedoes, radar and radio equipment, it pinpoints and destroys the submarine. Mission completed, the Wasp returns to base, an area smaller than the diameter of its rotor blades. Looking at bigger things, the Westland Belvedere, a twin-rotor helicopter powered by two Napier Gazelle gas turbines, capable of taking off with full load and landing on one engine with automatic transfer of power in the case of engine failure. A full load can mean, as here, 19 battle-equipped troops. Used extensively in the tactical mobility and support role, troops can be flown at short notice to the operational area. Soon over the area, the troops are quickly disembarked. And in moves the equipment, the transport, the weapons, the casualty equipment. Under slung loads of up to 6,000 pounds, easily and quickly transferred, irrespective of the state of the terrain. Equally at home, the Belvedere makes a call at the Westland London Heliport. The first British heliport built and operated as a private venture by Westland to provide data on installations, sighting and operational activity. Heliports are the key to city centre travel. Worldwide movements are increasing. Machines make a quick call with their passengers who have but a few minutes' journey to the city and the West End of London. Others leave with their passengers knowing that their journey time has been drastically cut. Helicopters and heliports. Westland, firm in the belief that the helicopter will play an increasingly vital role in the country's economy and security, look forward to the time when intercity helicopter services will free the traveller from the delays and frustrations caused by overcrowded roads and distantly sighted airline terminals. firm also in the belief that helicopters now being manufactured in Britain are backed by the most extensive development facilities and technical knowledge available. Backed by men who build quality and reliability into British helicopters. Backed by Westland, Britain's helicopter manufacturers.